Well, hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel. I hope life has been treating you kindly. So, I had a bit of a shocking moment the other day. I stood on the scale. I mean, that's a shocking moment in itself. I hardly ever weigh myself because, well, I never feel good about what I see. Anyway, I weighed myself and I discovered that for the first time in my life, I am in the range of what is considered to be obese. I'm not just chubby, you guys. I'm not just overweight. I'm officially obese. Now, I don't want you to get me wrong. I have never, ever in my entire life judged anyone because of their weight. I judge people by one thing and one thing only, whether or not they are an What someone weighs is between them and their doctor, and unless they choose to talk to me about it, I don't concern myself with it. You know, someone's weight is really no one else's business. I actually wish more people understood that. Social media is so full of sanctimonious people who think they have the right to tell other people how to live. A while ago, I made a video about things to consider when you're engaging with fat people. I'll link it in the description. Take a look if you're interested. Anyway, I just wanted to make it clear that my reaction to discovering that I am obese is not in any way a judgment of people who are obese. It's a judgment of me personally, and it kind of makes me reflect on how exactly I got to this point. I mean, I've been physically active for a large part of my life. How did I get to the point of obesity? The point of this reflection is not to beat myself up, but I think I need to examine this subject if I'm going to fix it. And as uncomfortable as it is to talk about it, it does reveal some truths about how damaging social messages and preconceptions can be. I have had a lifelong battle with my body image, and a lot of that is a function of the era that I was raised in. During my teenage years, the only acceptable weight was super thin. And if you weren't super thin, you were considered fat. There was no in between. There was no recognition of different body types. There was this one ideal standard of beauty, and being reed thin was part of it, even if your body was not naturally made that way. Now, I was very active when I was young. As a teenager, I swam competitively. I had swim practice every morning before school and every afternoon after school. I spent my weekends in our pool at home. I was always swimming. I was leading a very healthy, very active lifestyle. I'll just throw up some pictures of what I looked like back then. Throughout my teenage years, in spite of looking like this, I was consistently told that I was fat. I cannot point fingers at a particular person or people because this messaging was so pervasive. It was everywhere. It's just the way people were raised, especially girls. So at a time when there was nothing wrong with my body weight, I would love to look like that now. I had this absolute never-ending conviction that I was horrendously fat. And I wasn't alone. Almost all of my friends were experiencing the same thing. And almost all of us went on to have lifelong body image struggles. I'm pretty sure that by the time most of us were in our 20s, we had body dysmorphia. You know, that condition where you think your body is a different shape and size to what it actually is. For almost 40 years, I have hated my body. Absolutely hated it. At times, I have gone to all kinds of lengths to chase thinness, even when my body weight has been healthy. And for the better part of my adult life, my body weight has been healthy. I only know this from looking at pictures of myself from various points in my life, because I only ever remember seeing a fat girl looking back at me when I looked in the mirror. 3 years ago, I had a fall and injured both of my knees. I was very serious about running at the time, and I was in the middle of training for, I believe, my 12th half marathon. Of course, that year's running season came to a screeching halt. And when it came to my body and my weight and my activity level, things just kind of went downhill from there. I hardly ran at all last year. My last race was almost a year ago. My last run was almost a year ago. And here I am today, officially obese, going through perimenopause. Not fun, you guys. Not fun. The knees have long since recovered, but I've been experiencing chronic back pain. And I appear to have completely lost my running mojo. So I've decided to go out and look for it. A couple of weeks ago, I started following the program on this running app that I downloaded. Then I realized that the reason I always love to run is that I'm goal-oriented by nature and I have to have a goal race. Each of these medals represents a race that I've completed. I love to race. That's what kept me running before. And that's what will keep me running now. Or shuffling at this point. I definitely shuffle more than I run. My goal is to run a 10K race in May of next year. It seems like a lofty goal considering where I'm at now, but I know it's achievable. I'm ramping up gradually and just, taking it one day at a time. It's all about the baby steps. And the key thing for me is that I'm not doing it for my weight. I'm no longer going to chase an ideal that only exists in the minds of the people who used to tell me I was fat when I wasn't. I mean, as I get further into this running program, the weight will start to come down. The shuffling will morph into running. I may even get some reasonable speed going on. Soon I'm going to start to feel noticeable differences. I'll feel lighter on my feet. I'll have more energy. I'll be sleeping better. My flexibility will improve. I'll feel healthier. I'll be healthier. And one day I'll wake up feeling like I can't wait to get my shoes on and get out the door to go running. At that point, I'll know that I've found my mojo. I'm logging my fitness journey on my original YouTube channel that I kind of started years ago and then abandoned. If you want to follow along, I'll put the channel over here and I'll put it here and I will link it in the description down below. My closing message. From what I see on social media, some things have not changed since I was a teen. Young people are still being bombarded with unrealistic images of thinness and beauty. And if anything, the problem is even worse now because digital image manipulation tools are so sophisticated. Young people are now quite literally being expected to pursue something that does not exist, and that wouldn't be healthy if it did exist. I know that I am not alone in my experiences. Far from it. Almost everyone I know who grew up in the same era went through some version of what I just described. And we need to make sure that the messages we are giving to our kids are more positive. They need to start their adult lives knowing that they are fabulous, instead of feeling as if they're not good enough, not beautiful enough, not thin enough. Young people, you do you. Don't sacrifice your physical and mental health for someone else's ideal of what you should look like. And remember, most of what you see on Instagram isn't even real. That's it for today. I've rambled on for longer than I intended. If you're still watching, thank you for being here. If you're new, don't forget to subscribe to see more of my videos. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. That way I know that you're enjoying my content. I'll see you next week. In the meantime, stay safe, stay healthy, keep on social distancing, live your best life, and be kind. Bye!